Let's try that. Okay. Oh, getting a message from okay, Space Engineers. Opening up Space Engineers. Right. Did I save the title? I'm pretty sure I did. Okay. Just turn the microphone up just a little bit. I think I turned it down. Oh dear. Oh no, 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 no. Shush, 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 shush. Super loud splash screen. No thank you. Okay. Turn that down. Turn that up. Okay, so that's the dog. That's the picture of the dog. That's the actual dog. And Space Engineers is here. Brilliant. Okay, cool. Right. Join the game. Direct connect. Find the IP. Right. Need to keep this in an Evernote document or something. Right. Connect. Joining. Does it still have the password or is that whitelist implemented? Waiting for server to respond. Ah, brilliant. Okay, I guess social manager to put in the whitelist. Ooh. Right. Just going to get a beverage, a cold beverage, back in just one moment, if you please. Hello, sweet pea. Hello, my darling. Who's a good dog? Yes, you are. You are such a good dog. Yes, you are. Oh, things are bleeping at me. Right, I see the chat over there. Hello. Good morning, Duckslayer. Good morning indeed. How is work and stuff? Work and stuff is fine. So, just bear with me just a second. Sorry, just getting a drink. Okay. Who's on the server right now? Mega. Oh, Mega. He's down at on the desert. I'm assuming Earth. Right. Maybe turn the background ambience down just a notch. Step out of the cryopod. Turn off all the signals because they're a bit overwhelming. Still a vacuum in here. I've still got to figure out where there's a leak. Somewhere we've got the atmosphere escaping. I've set all the vents to depressurize currently, but it's a problem that needs to be solved. Ah, sweet. Someone's put in the inventory script management system. How cool is that? What is that? Auto crafting. What does that mean? Cobalt. Oh, it even shows our reserves of material. That's sweet. Wow, we can't have gone through all that magnesium. No fucking way. That can't be accurate. Wow, this is really useful. Holy shit, it's showing you exactly what we've got and what we need. We need a lot of gold. Is that true? 2.3 magnesium. I bought magnesium. No way! No fucking way! What do we make? No, I don't believe that. I bought back like a huge amount of magnesium. We can't have gone through all of that. Bloody hell. Anyway, thank you QuagerCool and Viceron and Vagrant and Speedo. Thank you all of you for your kindness. And good morning, folks. Good morning and welcome to your Tuesday, wherever you are in the world. And whatever it is you find yourself doing today. I hope you're having a lovely day. So just to bring you up to speed with what's currently happening, it's so as yeah, so it's Tuesday morning on the third week of work on the latest bullshittery, and that bullshittery is Rocket League Part 1. So far so good. I've just been working through the edit as best as I can. I continued work again this morning. I woke up a bit earlier and I just sort of cracked on with it. No huge problems. Everything's just kind of going, really. Just the edit proceeds, and yeah, I'll just let you know if anything goes wrong, really. Thank you, Shia Gorath. Thank you, sir. And Yo-Yon and Fisea Hawks. Thank you kindly, folks. That's very generous. So yes, as for right now, I'm just going to just play a bit of Space Engineers on the ZF server. Social did want me to tell you something, though. So the server is actually three servers now. So we've got three servers that are working together. And apparently you can switch... Let's just test it now. Hang on a minute. So it's switch, exclamation mark, switch, me. There we go. So let's see if this actually works. So apparently if you use the switch me command, you can just move between the different servers. But the servers are relatively open, Joson. So in order to join, apparently there's a ZF Discord, and you just need to send a message to CF Mag or Social, and the two of them will start going through... no faction. What's this? Earthlight Drop Medical Room. What's this? Yes, the two of them are just going to start going through names and start adding people, and I guess sort of play it by ear, really. Where am I? So yes, effectively you can join and just start building. Since there are now safe zones, so energy shields that you can set up, it's pretty much A-okay. You can just sort of join and do whatever you want, because if you don't want to lose something, you can just put it within a safe zone shield. So where are we? What is this place? I'm on Mars. So this is the Martian version. Is this the Thorn Sector? There's a moon. Mars has a moon. That can't be right. Was there always a moon on Mars? Or is that Earth? No, it's way too close. Well, I don't have my ship or anything, so I can't... Some sort of derelict station. It's been damaged. Don't know whose this is. Atmospheric drill ship. This looks like the one of the spawn stations you can get, but something's happened to it. Officer Black says, is there a new anti-Stasi in the nearest future? I think so. Vesper, a guy who often organizes it, was sending me messages late at night the other day. But it was way... I wasn't really paying attention. It was way too late in the evening. It was like 2 in the morning or something. What's this thing here? It's a small ship. It's an antenna system. What is this? Antenna ore detector. Oh, I see. It's a station-mounted ore detector that someone placed here to search for resources. Do we still need to be vouched for? I don't think so, the guy. I think they're just going to start going through and just kind of filling up the server, I think. Whoops. Whoops. Oh, Jesus. Lag. Whoa. Laggy. Fuck me. Okay. So, hang on a minute. So, let me just do that again. So, switch help. So, switch help. So, switch me. Switches to a selected server. So, I didn't have the server name. So, where am I? Switch list displays a list of valid server names to connect to. And switch grid is how I transfer the ship, not just me. So, switch list. So, we have the Floaty Gusset and Thorn Space. So, Floaty Gusset is the ZF one. Thorn Space is the PvP sector. I swear there was a third one. They told me there was a third one. Which is where most people are expected to join or something. I guess Floaty Gusset is it. Huh. Okay. So, switch. Oh, no, wait. Switch. Do I need these marks? Floaty Gusset. Oh, switch me Floaty Gusset? Ah, okay. Right, cool. All right then, so let's see how it goes. So I wonder if this is a better solution, as in multiple servers sort of spreading the latency a little bit, so we're not just all crammed on one. Ah. Hi there. Sorry, who's that? Silent Ranger. How's my day so far? So far, so good. Just woke up, did a bit of work, walked the dog. Now I'm back to stream for a bit, and then it's back to work. Thank you, Karma. Thank you very much, Karma. What's this? Milky Way Skybox. I didn't have this when I first connected. Okay. That is a lot, actually. 600 megs is way too much to download on a server switch. Yeah, that's not right. No, they've gone too far. That's the trouble. Whenever you mod things, don't go too far. I know it's tempting, but if you go too far, then you risk stability. What happened to RimWorld? It's all good, Eclipse. Nothing's happened to RimWorld. There are just many, many games to play. Isn't streaming my work? No, I'm a YouTuber, Nav Greybeard, so I edit. Editing is my work. Yes, and it's a very time-consuming process. Thank you, Nav Greybeard. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Right. Right. Okay, so there we go. And I'm back in the same position as I was before. Right, with all of my tools. That's cool. Okay, then. Whoa. Just give it a second to load. You're welcome, Ozzy. Thank you kindly for the compliments. Soviet, show us your titties, says Cocaine. Which is why I'm on a diet. Trying to, at least. Not doing very well, frankly. Okay. Right, sweet. So I'm just going to get back to work repairing my ship. So on the launch pad over there, on a building pad, you'll notice that there is a small capital ship. It's nothing particularly impressive, but it did let me escape the system in order to get some, well, I thought get some magnesium. I brought back a whole load of magnesium for weapons, but what's happened to it? Where's it gone? Seriously, I bought back like 100,000 units of magnesium, did I not? We're down to 2.3k? Somebody's built like a fuck ton of warheads or something? How did it go through that many? How's my car, Manji? The car's good. It's supposed to be going in for its... Ooh. Oh, that vent's still on. It's supposed to be going in for a service relatively soon. Who's made holes here? Were these always here? Weird. Anyway, so I'm just going to chill out and just keep building. So, yes, last night I had a slight teeny-weeny accident when I accidentally smashed the back of the ship into the terrain when the cargo bay was just way too full. So I was carrying way too much ore and I had far too little hydrogen fuel here. So I need to start enacting repairs. So we need to repair the hull of the ship. Whilst the refinery's out of order, it might be a good idea to take a moment to expand the back of the ship to put some hydrogen tanks here and here. So rather than just awkwardly strung up there. Yeah, just general repairs and improvements and stuff. What might be wise is just shimmying the front of the ship further forward. So let's just get into the vessel. And also fix that reactor leak because, well, reactors are not supposed to leak. What do I drive? Well, as the extremely famous YouTuber that I am, I obviously drive a Lamborghini, Ferrari, one of those. Something sporty. There we go, forward. Yeah, something like, not a Ford Fiesta, no. Thank you, Zombie Hunter. Thank you very much, Zombie. Thank you. There we go, and lock. Cool. So I've just shimmied the ship forward, and yeah, then I'm just going to start working on it then. Quite a lot of damage has been done to it. Right, so let's just also take off this awkward shield generator that I've got mashed on the front there. I still need to figure out how those shields actually work. I don't really understand them. Somebody said that I needed like a flux capacitor or something. Didn't really understand. Yeah, you mean a bus. Yeah, I'd take the bus. I'm getting to that age where I can get like a, you know, old person's discount, so make the most of it. Inventory full. Okay, so let's just remove these components. Get them back in the cargo space here so we can retrieve them later. Inventory full. Reliant Robin. Do they still make... No, they wouldn't make those. Thank you, Communism. Thank you very much, Communism. Thank you, sir. Inventory full. Hi there, Lord Python. Hello indeed.
Inventory full.
Hmm. Did you miss the Blizzard rant? I was seeing that. What was that about? I was reading Reddit before I joined. Something about... something to do with some player or something. Said something that... was it like a contest or something? You might have to tell me, because I don't know. Some player said something during some sort of contest and they got banned. But then what made me go, huh? Was that they said that the narrators got fired as well or something when they didn't say anything. What was that about? I don't really follow Blizzard stuff. Was it like a tournament or something? Hang on, right. Steel plates, storage special. Where can I find... Hang on. Oops, can't even spell. Construction components, storage special. Oh, no, wait. Is he putting them in named containers now? They banned the winner, who is a Hong Kong supporter, and fired the casters. So the casters are the narrators, yes? The commentators. Hong Kong protest Hearthstone winner says he supported it. Blizzard removed his prize money, his title, and fired the commentators. Why the commentators? What did they do? Did they say something? That's not a good look. That's really not a good look. Bit of a PR disaster there. Hi there, Alistair. Blizzard did exactly what they were told. Oh dear, that's really, really is a bad look. Okay, so I just need to make sure that this is roughly... Damn, I can't actually remember what the damage... Well, I could put the projector block back on, to be honest. Yeah, let's do that. Let's just... The trouble is I don't want to follow it one-to-one because I want to improve the ship, not just... find one of the command consoles. Here's one. So if I go here to the projector block, it should still... Yeah, it was intact. Cool. This will show me a projection of what was lost on the ship. Ah, yes, there was a huge wing that was ripped off, and the wing contains a bunch of engines which need to be replaced. Right. Also, good morning, Alistair. Good morning, sir. I hope you're a-okay. Blizzard want their cell phone game to be big in China. Oh yeah, is that the are they still beating that dead horse? What was it called? It wasn't Diablo. No, was it Diablo? What was it they were trying to do? They were trying to put something on mobile, and everyone laughed at them because it was like, is this an April Fool's joke? Was that Diablo or am I going insane? Sorry, I really don't keep track of the Blizzard stuff. I'm not all that interested in it. Is that Hearthstone? Sorry, is that what we're talking about? Oh no, Diablo Immortal. Got it, sorry. Right, I'm getting my... This was a while ago. Getting my wires crossed. Yeah, don't you guys have phones? I saw that on Reddit. I was like... And it was in front of a PC audience as well. What were they doing? It's mad. It's insane. That's almost as bad as the, well, probably is worse, but it's like the Dawn of War, turning Dawn of War into a MOBA. It's like, it's just not the audience, not the right audience at all. Like taking a franchise that is traditionally this thing and then trying to peddle it or, you know, trying to turn it into something else. How did they expect that was going to go down? That man was a poor, poor engineer, not a PR person. I did hear that, Urelez, yes. Something about the guy on stage who made that announcement. I was reading on the comments on Reddit that were saying, don't rail into him. He's just, you know, it's something like it's clear that he realizes how, you know, he's been pushed into this. Oh, man. Anyone remember what Ubisoft did to Dungeon Keeper? I think that's EA you're thinking of. Zadavir. Ubisoft doesn't own Dungeon Keeper. EA does. They're the ones that killed Bullfrog. Hmm. Incidentally, if you're actually a fan, if you were a fan of Dungeon Keeper and you weren't aware of this, the three of the former employees of Bullfrog that survived the sinking of Bullfrog, effectively, they reformed under, very briefly, they reformed under a different company, which unfortunately is no longer around, called Muckyfoot. And they produced a couple of games, but most notably they made a game called Startopia, which is brilliant. Alistair can back me up because he played it recently. Fucking really, really good. And it's on Steam. And I strongly, strongly recommend Startopia. It's basically Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy meets Theme Hospital. In that you're an alien overseer trying to make a station to serve workers or, you know, tourists. And they're all aliens and it's all very quirky and silly. It's very good. Hiya, Social. You miss Bullfrog and Westwood. Yes. Yes, all pulled down by the juggernaut of EA. Okay, right, so thruster components. I'm missing quite a few of these. Watching Soviet with your damn cat, says Blood. Hello to your... I probably shouldn't say that word because I'm going to get her excited. The CAT. Thruster components. We got loads. Excellent. Where's my builder ship? Yeah, somebody damaged it. Is it down here? Still not over the fact that I said Diablo. Is it not Diablo? Builder ship. Where's my builder ship? I parked it over. Oh no, I parked it over here, didn't I? I think I was loading. Yeah, yeah. So this is where I crashed. Look, here's the back end of the ship. With pieces of scrap metal everywhere. Alright. Let's grab bits of this maybe. Okay. Diablo. Pretty sure. Is it not Diablo? Right. Oops. Oh, shit. Oh! 11,000 magnesium ore. Some of it was left. Ah, right. Some of it was pulled into the refinery. All right, we better retrieve that. So what I've just done there, folks, is I've just removed one of the derelict refineries that was broken off the back of the vessel to reveal a whole chunk of unprocessed magnesium ore. I'll have to take pieces of this and place it into the base so it can be, well, turned into high explosives, bullets, that sort of thing. Might take a moment because I can only carry about 2,000 apiece. There we go. Energy low. Standby. I will just sit in the cockpit of my vessel here. My suit will interface with the battery on board and recharge. Good. Battery's almost full. Soviet, why am I British? Well, you see, Aussie, my mother gave birth to me on British soil as a British citizen. Therefore, by default, I become a British citizen with all the rights and protections. Of that. And I have to follow its laws, but, you know, and pay the taxes. But in exchange, I'm protected by its military and police force and have a large number of rights, which I enjoy as a result. Right, okay, so I'm just grabbing. What's that there? Gravel. Yeah. What's that? Platinum. Ah, all, yeah, all worth grabbing. Okay, well, what on earth? What the fuck? Oh, my character was going weird there. What right we led by Queen, mate? Aha, yes. I'm constantly seeing on Reddit. It's amusing me, but at the same time, I'm really shaking my head whenever I see it. Like, there was a thing on Reddit recently to do with, Boris Johnson. So, the current head of the Conservative Party, who are the current government in power here in the UK, challenges the Queen to fire him, or something along those lines. I'm sure it was some random soundbite that was taken from one of Boris Johnson's speeches. And then, reading the Reddit comments, people do not understand how our monarchy works at all. So many people were like, yeah, the Queen should... fire him. Yeah, like, the Queen has no fucking power. Like, I know it's all sort of technicalities, blah, blah, blah. She could do this, that, and the other. You must remember, when it comes to the Brit... the... What's the term? Monarchy in Parliament? There's a specific term for it. The Queen is a figurehead. She's a puppet. She doesn't give orders. She takes them. The Queen and the... Or the King, whoever's the sitting monarch, does not have any actual power. This is perhaps best demonstrated in the opening of Parliament. So the actual event where all the lords and all the MPs and everybody sits around and the actual opening, the ceremony to open Parliament, where the Queen is sitting on a gilded throne and she's she like gives a quick nod to... what's the name of the role? A specific parliamentary role. I can't recall the name. But basically to summon all of the MPs. And then the Queen reads a speech and everyone listens to the speech. Who writes that speech? The Prime Minister. She is a puppet. She reads out exactly what she's supposed to read out. She cannot object. She cannot put any inflection or emotion into her voice. She quite literally reads out the words of the sitting government. And if she does not, she is deposed. We fought a war over this. We chopped the king's head off over this. Sorry, thank you. The Black Rod Miner. Yes, that's the name of the the Queen's representative in Parliament. But yeah, it just surprises me when you read on Reddit, like how they're like, oh, the Queen can do this, Queen can do that. No, the Queen is a puppet. The Queen does exactly what she's ordered to do. The Queen does not give orders. She receives and complies, effectively. So why do you keep her around? She's a link to our past. She is in the same way that the Vatican derives its power from up high. The government in power derives its right to rule from the crown. But the crown has been effectively is now serving the government in power. It's completely flip flopped. You got to remember, effectively the monarchy is the servant of the elected government. It's really not the other way around. Even if the wording is exact to say, we serve at Her Majesty's pleasure. No, it's just a figurehead, a link to our past. And and no one wants to get rid of that link. It's a good link. It's good to have them around. You know, if anything, they provide a sort of, I suppose, like free diplomats in a way. Having a bunch, having some royals around to smooth things over. Maintain our connection to the Commonwealth countries. And just generally have good relations with our neighbours. Everyone wants, a happy diplomatic situation. It'd be terrible to get rid of it. Anyway, what am I talking about? Sorry, I'm getting distracted again. I keep babbling and I forget what I'm doing. So I bought this ship over. I've recharged the batteries. I've got the stuff from over there. I need to refill this ship and also repair the damage done to it. Stand by. Let's just put these in the cargo space. Yeah, and that jam. And the monarchy generates a lot of revenue for the country. I think there was a CGP Grey video that pointed out that... the lands that the royals own are... Well, the taxation that we're collecting off of them is worth a lot of money. And they're actually giving that up. They're giving it straight over to the government. Directly. Not to mention the tourism. So, it's a good source of revenue. It's a good source of prosperity and peace. Sure, though, not everybody thinks the same. Some people are like, yeah, down with the monarchy, blah, blah, blah. Republic forever. But, I think most people want them around, But don't think that the monarchy is the head, is in control of the United Kingdom. Oh, no. No, no, no. Right. Hang on a minute. So I just need to reach in here to grab the oxygen tank. So wait, hydrogen tank there, oxygen tank here. Thank you, Seth. Thank you very much, Seth. Thank you. Also, there's I mentioned that I mentioned this on Reddit a while ago, but there's that ceremony, the one to do with the opening of Parliament. There's this wonderful little event. There's this wonderful little ritual that they do every single time. I mentioned the Black Rod. Stand by. Projector block is on, but... Well, there it is. Ah! So I mentioned the Black Rod. That's the Queen's representative in Parliament. And his role is to, well, lots of different things, but effectively on the opening part of the ceremony, he is to, on the Queen's order, Queen or King, is to march over to the House of Commons and summon the MPs. Summon the MPs for the Queen's speech, for the opening of Parliament. And so he marches through the palace, hang on, of Westminster. Where is it? Yeah, there we go. Cool. So I just need to go repair the ship. Thank you, BuzzTech. Thank you. Yes, the Black Rod, I know. But yes, he's to march through and he's supposed to go to the House of Commons and he's supposed to barge in and demand the attendance of the MPs. As is tradition, as is ritual, every year he marches to the House of Commons and the MPs slam the door in his face. They just slam the door in his face and he has to knock. So he has to knock and they let him in. This is effectively to symbolise that our government is not beholden to the monarchy, that it's the other way round, that they will not comply. It's in response to, is it King James? Hang on, bear with me. Which king did we behead? Charles I, I'm so sorry. It's in response to Charles I when he barged into the House of Commons to arrest some MPs. Since then, it's been a tradition that we slam the House of Commons doors in the face of the Black Rod in order to say, nope, our government is elected by the people and, you know, effectively you can't boss us around. We're in charge, not you. We invite you in. You don't make demands, you take them, you know. That sort of thing. It's cool. It's a cool ritual. You can see it on YouTube. It's just one of those little sort of things, a relic that we, a link to our past. So this isn't actually lined up, so I just need to sort this. There we go. Right, now it's linked up. Thank you, Lapop and Jesus and BuzzTech. Thank you very much. King James and King Charles were the same. Wait, sorry, am I getting mixed up? Sorry, probably haven't got the facts all the way through. Cromwell, we chopped the king's head off. Whoops. So what I'm doing in the game now is I'm just dragging the... Well, I'm moving the ship beneath a pair of welders that are connected to the construction network. The logistics network of the base. And the welders are painting the missing blocks on. So there's just a welder there. Oh, bugger. I've loaded the wrong blueprint and it's in fact built some grinders. Crap sacks. That's not what I wanted. Gotta fix that. So the older blueprint, so grinders will remove blocks. I want welders. That one is a welder. That was fine. Shit. Oh dear. Lag. Fuck. There we go. So go to welders. Let me turn off the projector block. I can't fucking see. Okay. Cool. So yeah, we don't really need grinders anymore. I'm not really grinding down anything specific. Although I do want to go and retrieve the large ship that's on the hill that I was building. It's got some parts that will prove useful to us. So I want to go and lift these parts down into... No, but what am I doing? Small... Oh dear. Someone's been dumping off all their tools. Build planner controls are in F1, advanced controls at the bottom. Okay. Okay, not all of the welders are in the welder group. Let's just add them. Cool. Sweet. Right. Let's go. And upsy-daisy. Oh yes, I didn't put any up thrusters on it. Because I figured that we'd just be able to lean the craft down. If not England, where would I like to be born? England's fine. Fine by me. It's all good. Okay. So, hang on, let me just check the cargo bays. No, we need to refill the ship. My bad. So let's get all these... we'll get all the thruster components and load them up and then just do all the ion thrusters. Okay. Yes, me and some of the ZF guys, we actually popped into the Westminster. We went into the House of Commons. So where the MPs are all jeering. We sat in the viewing gallery. Which it's quite interesting. We just sat there for a while. We watched a debate. I can't remember what it was on. They were debating. There weren't that many MPs. They were debating something. Burko looked incredibly bored. He looked so bored. I thought he was about to pass out. He just looked so tired. Well, you know, clearly whatever was being debated was kind of boring. But yeah, it was good. Just sitting in the House of Commons. It looks much bigger on telly. It's really small. I'm like, bloody hell, this room is tiny. Although apparently, I was reading that they're actually moving out of Westminster. They're actually temporarily relocating to a different building in a few years because it turns out that they keep having fires in Westminster because the building is so old. It was built before air conditioning and, well, modern electricity. So as a result, they keep having fires, and just it's really hard to just keep just plumbing and electrical work is really hard to maintain. So they're going to move the government operations elsewhere, and then they're just going to strip the fucking thing. They're just going to go through the building, and they're just going to fucking gut it. They're going to redo it. It needs modernization really badly. So yeah, they're going to spend a few years. I think it's like until 2026 or something. And they're just gonna try and fix this problem because they're putting it off again and again and again. And hang on a minute, what? Large cargo. Where's that big large cargo container with all the inventory in it? Oh, it's gone. Huh? Where's it gone then? Steel plates? Has he made separate? I think he's made separate things. That's gonna be slightly confusing. Wait, this is my own ship. Let's order up a bunch more stuff. Someone's done lots of building and they've drained everything. Okay, construction components. Is there still scaffolding around Big Ben? I don't know, sorry. Someone might have to... I don't live in London. Hi, Social. Social says, the fires are started due to the old wiring and faulty machinery. Yeah, it's a really fucking old building. Yeah. Thank you, Soul Reaper and Mantazzo and Duke Mars. That's very, very generous. Thank you, guys. And Fragment, and a lap open. Thank you kindly. Okay, let's also get some steel tubes. Get about 100 of those. Oh yes, and of course the thruster components. Did I grab all of those? Thruster, I think I did. I got a bunch of them, didn't I? Probably going to need more than that. Well, let's go. If I could legally have any firearm, what firearm attachments and why? I realise this is not an opinion shared by everybody, and that's fine. But I'm of the opinion that a civilian population shouldn't necessarily have access to firearms. Not without extremely good reason. Of course, there are some extremely good reasons. Perhaps you live in an area where predators are a problem. In which case, yes, definitely, 100%. But if you don't... then you shouldn't have access to a device which is capable of taking another human life, particularly a handgun, which pretty much serves only that purpose because you can't really hunt with a handgun. Again, to each their own. That's just my personal opinion. Can I not reach in there? Hang on. Indeed, carrot whiskey. In fact, I believe in East Sussex, so where I live, there was a... Oh, wait. Oh, damn, I don't even have to steal. There was an attempt to reintroduce the wild boar. We hunted them to total extinction in the United Kingdom, and we got a bunch of European wild boar and reintroduced them. It's been a little too successful. The wild boar population in East Sussex has exploded, and the farmers are really not happy. yeah. There's now several hundred wild boar running around. So yeah, it turns out the wild boar are actually very, very good at breeding. Right. I think there was a discussion a while ago, or at least I read on Reddit a while ago, that they were thinking about reintroducing the wolf. Again, we hunted the grey wolf to total extinction. We've hunted a fuck ton of things to total extinction here in the UK. It's a small island. And, you know, we hunt things. I think that was a much less popular proposal. Right. Why would we reintroduce one of the most prolific pests in nature? Because they're not necessarily a pest when they have a place in the ecosystem, and other creatures, other animals which they would eat, or, you know, plant life that they would keep under control, is sort of growing out of control because, well, we've gone and taken out an important piece of a delicate ecosystem. You know? You take out one cornerstone species, then others start growing out of control. Although I can't tell you what specifically the problem was with wild boar. There must have been a problem. Maybe someone can Google it and tell me. Why did they reintroduce... What was the problem? Or was it just a case of, well, they're supposed to live here, so we really should? Except their place in the ecosystem has changed. Boar didn't have any predators in Britain since the wolf's extinct. Sure, but what were they eating? What were they supposed to keep under control? Hang on. I'm curious. Why were wild boars reintroduced? UK. Wild boar important for meat farming. Oh, really? Here comes the trouble. The return of wild boar. Here we go. So the animals are re-emerging. Okay, so at the base of beech trees, bluebell roots. All right, so deliberately reintroduced a couple of years ago, they found themselves staring down the wrong end of our conflicting attitudes towards the wilderness. We wanted them because they once belonged here. Oh, wait. Oh, shit, sorry, it's the Guardian. Sorry, ignore that. I was reading a thing from the Guardian. Sorry. Yeah. Their diet is basically plants and berries, so... I'm not sure, sorry. I don't know the answer. I don't know why they were reintroduced. Oh shit, is that heavy armor? Damn. I've still got heavy armor blocks. They're too expensive. Yeah, fire. We should perhaps put out the fire. How many thruster components do I still have aboard? Quite a few. There we go. Propaganda, Simic. Some newspapers or tabloids are propaganda in the UK. Not all of them are news. Right. Construction components, large steel tube. There we go. Large steel tubes. Put that steel away. I don't need. Yeah, some derelict steel. Scrap metal. Thrusters. What was the other thing? 20 construction components. Yeah, what is the build planner thing? Is that the middle mouse? Is that what you mean? Yeah, I need to get used to doing that. Sorry, I'm like an old school Space Engineers player. I'm not used to the new thing. So how does one do it again? It's... Hang on. So middle... Middle mouse? Middle mouse. And then... Middle mouse. Yes? No? Batteries. Why would I grab batteries? Shift middle mouse? What am I doing wrong? Sorry. Oh, thank you, Death Monk. Thank you very much, Death Monk. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Right click on unfinished things, middle mouse. Oh, I see. Right click. And then middle mouse? Put that away. Ah! Hey! Right click the middle mouse. Ah, thank you very much. Yeah, I need to get used to that. Sorry, that's very new. Or at least new to me. Right click, middle mouse. Right click, middle mouse. So I'm telling like a... It's sort of caching what I need in like a small like recording, and then it's grabbing them. Whee! Yep. Cool. Components added to the build planner. Cannot withdraw 80 thrust components, I imagine, because they're just too heavy. But we can get most of the rest. white wood laminate. Yeah. Cannot withdraw?
Why?
Oh, do we just not have them? Oh, we just don't have them. That would explain it. So let's go to the main assembler and order up. Oh, why is it doing this again? That's annoying. So the main assembler, so none of the slave assemblers have gone and taken their orders. Slave assemblers, explain yourselves. Somebody switched off cooperative mode, that's why. Slave assemblers, off you go, get to work. And assembler main, there we go. There we go, slave assemblers are off. Yeah, so effectively there is one assembler which is queuing up the orders of the entire base. And then the slave assemblers will pick up the slack. Right. Thank you, Death Monk, again. That's very kind. And the Asian Prince and Soul Reaper before that. Thank you, folks. That's very kind. Thank you very much. Right. Just grab that build planner. Cannot withdraw. That's because we don't have them. But I can certainly get the rest of them. Yeah, right click. And then... Bloop. That is cool. I like that. I like that a lot. So if I just go back and just middle mouse, will it remember or will it just pull the same shit? I'm not sure. It's cool though. I like that. Oh. Favorite internet historian video. Oh, he's done so many great ones. I like the ones he's done on the two conventions. The, Rainforest and... What's the other one? Not Fire Festival. That's a good video. Rainforest and there's one that Tumblr did? What's it called? DashCon! Thank you, Hitman. Thank you. Yes, if you're not familiar, sorry, we're talking... A YouTuber called The Internet Historian. He does these wonderful just sort of presentations where he just talks about something that happened on the internet and just how it went horrendously wrong. And one of them is talking about a convention. It was a furry convention where the attendees were a bit more energetic than expected, causing lots of damage to the hotel that they stayed at, which then caused that hotel to, I think, I don't know if it threw them out, but it certainly told them that they wouldn't be allowed back at that venue. But then apparently what happened, according to this video, is that the hotel then told other hotels not to host that convention, and so from that point onwards the convention just was shut down because they couldn't, no hosting venue would take them because they were just so destructive, like breaking elevators and plumbing, and didn't they break a jacuzzi or something, somebody like stuffed a bunch of towels in a jacuzzi, they put towels in the water filter for like a pool or something. And they cause like thousands of pounds worth of damage. Like not like a little bit. Like, you know, they've really fucked that place up. Or something. And what was the other one? The other one was a Tumblr convention that... Oh, what went wrong? It was... The people managing it had never run a convention. And so it was a total confusing clusterfuck. Where they couldn't even pay the fee that the hotel demanded or something. Oh yes, and then the game room consisted of a ball pit. Like a tiny little ball pit that someone pissed in. Oh man. Hmm. Yeah, internet historian. Very, very good videos. Again, I mentioned this last night, but he just kind of like presents like the phrase that my old boss used to use, just give them a rope and let them hang themselves. In other words, you know, just you don't need to embellish it. You just need to show them at work and you realize just how bad it is. So he doesn't need to inject every video with his personal opinion. He just presents what happened and you're like, what? Did that really happen? Oh my god, that really happened. Thank you, Divot. Thank you very much, Divot. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Divot. Tumblr was the ball pit. Sorry, yes. Apologies if I'm not really familiar with these. I'm not really familiar with Tumblr. Oh, and the Tumblr versus 4chan. I'm much more familiar with 4chan. Much more familiar. Although old 4chan, rather than the new one. But yes, when they try. when they tried to take on B, when Tumblr tried to take on B, what do you think was gonna happen? Kick the hornet's nest, indeed. Thank you, Willem. Thank you very much, Willem. Thank you kindly. Sorry again, I'm losing the plot. I keep forgetting what I'm doing. I'm trying to get thrust components so I can get the ion engines going on the ship, and I need to now switch off the projector block. Yes. So now that we've got the wing built, let's switch off the projector block so I can try and expand the back of the ship with additional hydrogen tanks. Who's 4chan? An infamous hacker. Hacker man. Okay. Right, so yes, what I need to do here is I'm probably going to remove this refinery and that pipe. So yeah, put this hydrogen tank flat here. And then build the frame around it and have the hydrogen engines threaded underneath and at the back. Yeah, all right. Cool. And how much hydrogen does the tank contain? Let's have a quick look. 13%. It should be fine. Okay. Well, I could probably just build another. We'll save. Yeah, just build like an alternate tank over here. Just to transfer the fuel. Just to keep it safe. Right. Ugh. So let's go and... What am I doing first? So can I just right-click on that? No, I guess not. Put a tank just somewhere temporary. Just hit him. Put it on that piston. No, that's not enough room. I just want to transfer that hydrogen fuel somewhere. I know what to do. But yes, for the people joining the stream, I hope you're having a lovely, lovely morning so far. I'm just playing a bit of Space Engineers, then I'm going to bugger off and get on with the latest edit for YouTube in a little bit. Currently working on Rocket League bullshittery. So far, so good. No real problems. Just sort of cracking on, really. Right, so I'm just going to give me a bit of room, shimmy back, and then put the hydrogen tank at the front. Lift the nose up a little bit. There we go. Right. Didn't Tumblr collapse when they banned porn? Oh, yeah, that was that. Yeah, something like that happened, didn't it? Damn. Blocked. Move the piston down just a notch. Control panel piston. Move it down just an itty-witty bit. And then just... No, can't place it here. Never mind. Can I place it here? I can. There we go. Large steel tubes. Whoa, what the fuck? There goes some large steel tubes. Come back! Da-da-da-da. Right, so right click and then middle mouse. Cannot withdraw thruster components. Is that because my inventory is full? Middle mouse. Wait. Ah. Hey, that is a very cool system. I like it. Thank you, Dr. Liquid. Thank you very much, Doctor. Thank you, sir. Right, so with this secondary tank... Right, secondary tank, empty. Call this secondary tank temp. Okay, and then tell temp to stockpile and the other one not to. Stockpiling on. Oh. Does this imply that the link has been severed? Damage done to the conveyor system? Yep, it's not actually connected anymore. Easily remedied by putting down a conveyor tube. Thank you, Dr. Liquid and Bobbick and William. Thank you very much. Thank you sincerely. Spin that round. Right, there we go. That should now be draining the tank. Let's have a look. No, it's not for some reason. Stockpile, yes. What have I done wrong here? How have I done goofed? That's connected. The connection must be broken somewhere. Yeah, maybe the crash did more damage to the superstructure than I expected. Goes through this cargo bay, that's correct. Conveyor. Conveyor. Oh, yeah, that's fine. Auto refill, that's bottles, that's not. That should be fine. Am I going mad? Strange. It will fill the stockpile tank first, indeed, so which is why I set that one to stockpile. I'm not sure, sorry. I don't know what the problem there is. The ship has power. Well, yeah, there's a slight uranium leak. It's fine. Good for your bones. Not sure. You think hydrogen can't go through the cargo containers? Do you reckon? Do you reckon? I've not heard about that before. Oh, it's fine. Fuck it. We'll just get more ice. We've got an entire ocean of ice over there. Alistair says, no, it can go through anything. Yeah. What am I missing? But it's really obvious. It's like, duh. Was it working before the crash? I hadn't built a hydrogen tank at the front before the crash. Okay, maybe a junction is damaged. Yeah. Yeah. Maybe I haven't aligned it properly? I think I have. Oh! What? Oh! Am I just being a dumbass? Was I just looking at the wrong thing? It's filled. It's moved it. Okay. I have no idea what that was. Let's assume I'm an idiot. Safe assumption, I think. Right. Now I can remove the tank. Okay, so let's now. Where am I going to put this shit? So I need to take off the refine. Where's my builder ship? Let's stick it all in here. Okay, a useful container nearby. I'll move the builder ship back over. Right. Da 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 da. Social says you just got the lovely task. You worked on a project and made a calculation folder, roughly 400 pages, all signed and countersigned. It was all in order and presentable. I just had to return to my desk, missing all the poly wallets individual calcs were in, and the pages shuffled. Oh, really? Okay. Whoops. Have fun with that, social. Have fun with that. Yeah, I could put grinders on the builder, but I think we're good for now. I'm not having to grind away a huge amount. Just a little bit, mainly. He says, having to grind away quite a bit now, but you know what I mean. It shouldn't be too much of a problem. What is this? Is this a cockpit? Hang on. Connector protected. Let me just cut the damn thing off. The rest will just fall down. There we go. Pick these up in a bit. Okay. And then I want to kick this off. Where is it attached? Oh. Alright, never mind. Cool. Oh dear. Similar story. Whole load of magnesium ore. Okay, now then. So what I want to do is I want to put the hydrogen tanks here. Can't fall to the ground. Okay. So the hydrogen tanks are effectively going to sit in the spine of the ship. Like this, I suppose. Is there an... Oh, there is. There's a top access port. That could be convenient. I need all this junk to move out the way first. But yeah, if we put a couple of tanks and then just have quite a bit of fuel available, the jump drive can sit either above or below them. Cool. That is indeed in line. I just need this... Yeah, that would work really well. Just need to move this crap. Great. Bugger off. Fine, I'll start loading up. Ah! See, I've got a better idea that's super complicated. Nah. Is it? Haha! No, watch this. I'm going to be a genius. You ready? Well, it's going to take me a few minutes. Yeah. Genius does take time. But here we go. Right, watch this. You see this? Yeah. Right, this is a spherical... gravity generator. Okay? Now what this means is that it can generate gravity in a sphere. As opposed to pointing straight down. So technically normal gravity as opposed to weird sci-fi gravity which only goes directly down. And then what I'm going to do... Take these... Oh, damn. Okay, hang on. Oh, fuck. I'm just going to fling this stuff on the floor because, you know, fuck it. I'm going to make some litter. Yada. There we go. Okay, so right click. Fly. Yoink. Fly. What? Mind my head. Okay. Fly. Yoink. Ta-da. Yoink. Baldrick level plan going on. Oh, a single gravity component at a time. God damn it. They're just really heavy. Obviously, because they're made out of gravity. That's what makes them heavy. Clearly. Standby. For some reason, I can never seem to interface with the moon's antenna, and I don't know why. Okay, wait for a second. Well, the moon base's antenna. So, gravity. Spherical gravity generator. Let's switch it off. Hey. Ta-da. Ta-da. Right, then, watch this. Genius move. Okay. Right. See? Perfect. See this? It's going to be perfect. You're going to be amazed. You ready? Here we go. Then. Ignore that. That's fine. It's all part of the plan. Steel plates. Is there shit in the way? Yes. Ah, steel plates. That's exactly what I need. Be gone. Fuck you. Get out of it. Hang on. Fuck off, steel plates. There you go. Steel plates have fucked off. Da 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 da. Ah. Small steel tubes. I require some. Any small steel tubes? Aha! Ah. Ugh. Right click, build planner. Whee! You ready for this? I'm ready for this. Motors. Some down here.
Inventory.
Ow. Just burnt myself on my own thruster. God damn it. Where's some motors? Motors, 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 motors. Aha, I see
inventory
some motors.
Full.
God damn you. What's this? The big heavy tubes. Da 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 da. Thank you, Raw Hate. Thank you, sir. Right. That looks backwards. Wait, what? There we go. Right, a chute, as you can see. A funnel that leads into the ship. Now, all I have to do, is, like the extremely intelligent individual that I am, is switch that gravity generator on, and all of this crap will fly towards it at speed and enter the inventory. It's going to look amazing. You ready for this? Right. Just going to drop some more stuff here. Just to assist with the demonstration. Ready? Okay, here we go. So, doing this, I can do the work of, like, 100 men. Hang on. Control. control station. Damn, steel plate. Steel plate, steel plate, steel plate. And construction component. And displays. God damn it. Right, here we go. So I just do this. And then I go spherical gravity generator. And I think radius, call about, about 170. No, less than that. About 100 meters. Gravity is good. 1G. That should be good enough. And voila! As you can see, everything is just flying straight. Okay, that's a bit bigger than I wanted. But it's all going. Why is that ship groaning and creaking? No magnesium, not you. Oh fuck, it's all kind of stuck to it. I wanted it in the chute. What if I rub the chute against it? Will that work? Hang on. Da 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 da. There we go. Not quite what I wanted, but hang on. Da da da. Ha ha! Ha ha! Sort of. Hang on. Go on, just. Damn it, I can't put the spherical gravity generator behind the chute. Oh, fuck off. Come on, in the chute. Yeah, no. Fuck. Hang on, what if I. Aha. No, watch this, it's fine. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go. So, moon base. Uh huh. Spherical gravity generator. Ready? And then I'm going to reverse the gravity so it things go away from it. So items are repulsed. Just like how women are repulsed from me in public. As you see, they all slide away at speed. But not into the damn chute. Get into the chute. No, 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 no. Oh, fuck. Fuck. Hang on. No, this is not what I wanted. Wait. Spherical moon base, spherical gravity generator, maximum anti-gravity. Okay, it's going that way now. Whee! And then back again. Get in the chute, in the chute, in the chute. No, not that. Magnesium, bugger off. Bugger off, bugger off. Okay, maybe I should just pick things up with my hands, eh? Well, I thought it was going to work. Can I stick things in the chute directly?
Inventory full.
Inventory full. Hang on, fucking. Ugh. Now it's in the way.
Inventory full.
Fine. be that way. Connector. At least I know where it all is. It's cool though, isn't it? You can set up spherical gravity generators. Looks pretty cool. Tell you what, you wanna see something that looks even cooler? Watch this. Oops, need more steel. Put this there. Ah, it should be fine. Right, then. Just drop my shit off, hang on. Motors, where's some motors? Any motors stuck in there? Yep, there's a couple there. And some computers. Any computers stuck on there? I can't see any. Go grab some. Whee! Drop off this and this and this. Just grab some computers. Anyway, for the people just joining the stream, I'm just building my ship. Then this. Okay, cool. Right.
Inventory full.
Stick it up here, right?
Inventory full.
Each individual gravity component is quite beefy. So I've got to lift them up here. There we go. Spherical gravity generator engaged up there. And now... Well, it's not a very good example. What I was hoping would happen is that as the pieces come off of the ship, as I deconstruct it, they'll sort of start spinning around in orbit. But this giant piece of magnesium has fucked it right up. Bugger off, you bastard. Actually, to be fair, this magnesium is pretty valuable. Better hang on to that. Good for explosives and bullets and stuff. Thank you, Crammed. Thank you very much, Crammed. Thank you, sir. And thank you, Dex. Thank you very much, Dex. Put the gravity generator and cover it all around with funnels and stuff. Yeah, could do that. Yeah, and then have things go wah and fall in. Is there a pipe that leads over here? No. Thank you, Execution Phoenix. Thank you very much, Execution. Hang on. Did I find the leak? No, I can't figure out where it is. It's somewhere in the base, but I don't know where. You have to reduce the gravity strength for it to orbit. Alright. That can be arranged. Control panel. Thank you, Scorby. Thank you very much, Scorby. Drop its radius down. Drop the acceleration down to about that. Yeah. Oh, hang on. Is the moon's gravity stronger? So disable the thing. Things are now sliding off following the moon's gravity. I'll just, easier than that. I'll just repulse. Yeah, come to think of it, the moon's gravity is going to make much less of an impressive demonstration. The things are just going to be pulled down, aren't they? Spherical gravity generator. Repulse. And then pull back in at about... Yeah. Nah, they're just going to stick to it, aren't they? They got two separate forces of gravity acting on them. Pretty neat though, isn't it? So yeah, you can put loads of connectors down here if you wish, and just switch it off, and then it'll just go straight in. Yeah. Right. Okay. Okay. So what was I doing? So yeah, I was just cracking on building the ship. Let's continue that effort. So let's get some hydrogen tanks around the back. How is everyone this morning? You all okay in the chat? I know Social's probably pulling his hair out because of that project thing. Anybody up to anything particularly interesting this morning? Ba, 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 ba. Okay, so hydrogen tank here. We'll put it sideways. And then we'll put two... Yeah, another one here. And this will be our primary source of fuel. All good, says Thozzle. Getting food, says Purple. Starting your new job, Boydka. Well, good luck. You're fine, says Roy. Just tired. Working, says Crying Scum. Classes, says Darth Kura. Looking for work, says Lemon Cake. Good luck. Pretty crappy, but you're going to PAX this weekend, says Walken. Have fun. Power washing, says Rise. Ooh. Cool. University is sucking you dry, says Android Wolf. Sorry to hear that, man. Yeah, well, I hope you have a better day. I hope everybody has a good day. Right, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to put down conveyor junctions. 1, 2, 3, 4. And this will form a spine of 4 downward-facing hydrogen thrusters, which will eventually be sheathed in metal. So like so. 2, 3, 4. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring down the hull of the ship. So we'll put some stairs that travel down. Then the new base of the ship will be down here. And I'm going to do a similar thing on the sides. Yeah, but basically giving us omnidirectional hydrogen thrusting in the middle section of the ship, saving the ions for the front. How long will I be streaming for today? Probably another 40 or so minutes, and then I need to bugger off and get on with work. So I'm just going to pour myself another drink. And what's the dog doing? Yeah, she's okay. She's just resting. She had a good play this morning with a bunch of cockapoos. So a poodle that is crossbred with a cock. But yes, a very energetic dog. A very popular breed, actually. But she loves having a good run around and a chase. A roll in the mud. Yeah, Lulu's okay. Really, Halo? You're working in a morgue? Blimey. It's pretty grim. I suppose we've all got to do what we've got to do. But all the best, man. All the best. Okay, conveyor junctions, like so. And then the pipe... Yeah, the piping will probably continue to the end anyway. Okay, and then where's the jump drive going to live? That's a good question. I need to restore the jump drive. Put it in the middle here. Getting rid of these downwards facing ion thrusters and yeah, because the ion thrusters can live anywhere. So I can make these ion thrusters live on the sides of the jump drive. But then again, they are the floor. I might have to rethink that if I'm going to put the jump drive there. Well, hell, we could put it under the front. Yeah, that could be a good place for it here. Like, literally underneath the cockpit. So the jump drive is a FTL, effectively. Yeah, it could be a really cool place to put it, actually. Oh, pardon me. Indeed, I live in the United Kingdom mountain. I'm a British man living on Great Britain. The biggest island of the chain. Right. Is that... Oh, no. That looks stupid. How does that look? So obviously it's a bit stupid right now, but I will surround... Yeah, so I'll surround it in like a sheath of armor to protect it. Right, cool. Right, let's get this bit built. What have I got in my inventory currently? Scrap metal. It's going to float off towards that gravity generator. Also, I'm quite low on O2. I'm going to have to get some more from the base momentarily. Switch on the welders. There we go. So the materials that I've got inside the cargo bays are effectively painting the hydrogen tank onto the frame. Thank you, Astro. Thank you very much, Astro. Thank you sincerely. Leokia says, the problem is getting an interview in the first place. You've had 1 month experience at a job so far, so no one wants to have someone at your experience level. That sucks indeed. Sorry to hear it, Loika. Yeah, I remember. I think it's been a long time since I've done an interview. But I remember going through so many of them. What annoyed me about the interview process was it, you know, this whole sort of embellishment thing. You know, you're expected to embellish your experience levels. I don't know. It just felt really... I don't know. I never liked it. Everyone was just lying to everybody. Because if you told the truth, well, you know, the next guy's going to get it. Right. Have I noticed a giant hole in the station window leaking O2? Is it in the window? I don't think so. There is a leak, though. Right, just going to pop over and yeah, get a fresh bottle of O2. Indeed, remember that you're interviewing them as well. That's true. Always have follow-up questions whenever you're going to an interview. Make sure you've done your research into the company. Find out what a typical day for you would look like. Find out what, what's the average sort of time that people have been working there, that sort of thing. Look for some red flags, like a high staff turnover, or when the interviewer doesn't have a strong understanding of the job that they're pitching. That's always a bad sign. Right. Oh yes, I should use the part planner, shouldn't I? Fun fact, you got your job without an interview. Your current boss just called you and offered you a job. Yeah, I worked in software development, and yeah, as it often goes with these sorts of things, you know, everybody kind of knew everybody else. Or rather, you start working at a new company, and then your company says, well, we really need this type of dev, and you know that you've got like a few people that you used to work with, and you're like, hey, do you want to come work for this other company? It's like, yeah. But then again, that was just kind of came with the territory, as in people just jump between different companies all the time. I suppose it depends. Probably a lot of industries like that these days. But you sort of bounce between whichever job to get the best salary you can, really. Which was a bit annoying, because it often meant that you'd be working on a project and the guy that coded a thing has long since left the company. You're like, ah! How does this work? No idea! What did we document? Nothing! Ah, as is tradition. Oh, I've lost the music. Hang on. Yeah, that's another red flag, Duck Slayer. Oh, God. Yeah, we're more like a family than a workplace. Sorry, that does tick me off. I remember going to... I enjoyed working at the last company that I worked for up in London. It was good. But the management would have like these big team... like team building sort of business meeting type things in which they gather you all in a room. And they'd have you sort of try to talk about ways. It was like brainstorming ways in which they could get better productivity out of people without paying them. And so they were offering like all these different incentives and like, well, what if we did this? What if we changed our working procedures like this? And it was kind of, I remember I chickened out. I didn't want to just say the obvious, which is just pay us overtime. You know, just fucking... We're not working because, oh God, I just have a passion for working on shitty apps or whatever. You know, as in like this app for a client in Hungary or something. Oh God, it's my dream. No, we're working because you're paying us money. Just give us more money and we'll do more work. You know. But no, you can't say that. No. Yeah, what do you want? Better productivity. Fewer meetings like this? Yeah. Hang on a second. I'm just going to put the music, a different music thing. What have we got? Nope, that's a live version. Don't do that. Yeah, that's all do. Money is a taboo. Yeah. I know that, yeah. Right, right click, components added. Just make sure we got the, make sure we got the grids. Do we have the grids? Yeah, we got loads. All right. Why would it need thruster components on my build planner? Is there a way of wiping the build planner? Oh, can I only carry four at a time? Surely not. No, sorry, I'm not dissing Hungary, Dave. I'm just saying in terms of making apps for clients. No, you know, all of the developers or QA or PMs or whatever, I doubt they all sort of, oh yeah, I really, really just love developing apps. Yeah. No, you know, you're getting paid. That's why you wake up in the morning. You're getting paid. So why am I not grabbing things now? What's the problem? This song, it's something by Carbon-Based Lifeforms. I think it's called World of Sleepers or something. Sorry, what am I doing wrong here? I'm making some sort of a mistake. Or is it just the overlay that's being silly? Press G to the bottom right window. Ah, that's what that is. Okay, cool. Right, gotcha. Right, so if I go... Oh, wow. Hang on. So, bish... No. Yes. Ha-ha! It records the specific blocks. Oh, wow. Love it. I love it. That's awesome. Sorry, I thought it was like, hey, you know, just conveyor junction, whatever. But no, it's recording the specific blocks that you want to do. I love it. It's cool. Holy shit. That's great. How cool is that? It's like a... It saves exactly the specific blocks on the grid. Not just that general type. Thank you, Condensed Sky. Thank you very much, Condensed. All components successfully withdrawn. And then, does it clear the list? It clears the list! How sweet! How fucking sweet is that? Holy crap, love it. Brilliant. Fab. That's awesome. So, bish, bash, bish, bash, bosh! Right, okay. Whee. Okay. Hi there, Nyan. Hello. Thank you sincerely. Thank you for the compliments. Welcome indeed, Nyan. Sorry, Nyan Pyre. Yes. Well, you probably find it a bit different from the YouTube stuff, because the YouTube stuff is obviously a heavily condensed compilation of moments over a lot of time. Lots of time. Sometimes many, many months of streams. Whereas this is just me playing with whoever. Yeah, I'm just sitting on the ZF server, but most of them in the morning are at work. They tend to be around in the evenings or on the weekends. So yeah, you'll probably just find me babbling or answering questions or ranting about EA or talking about fishing. Pick two. Thank you, Balthazar. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Wait, what did I grab? Nothing? Oh. Alright. Just keep... There we go. Ooh, bit of lag there. Round about Halo. Why? What's happening in Halo? Newest fishing toy? Indeed. So I purchased some more fishing gear. I've purchased a specific spod rod. Effectively, when you go fishing, there's an act that you can do called spodding, which is the distribution of bait at long distance to try and attract fish. But I tried to do it last Tuesday. Was it Saturday? No, Saturday. And it turns out that the line that I was using was not strong enough, nor was the rod. So the bait that I was trying to cast snapped off and went flying into the water, which was very embarrassing. So I bought like a hardened rod phrasing, which I'm hoping will remedy that little problem. I've also bought some something called a glug pot and a sort of not sure what to call it. It's like a flavoring. You sort of dip the bait in it, and the idea is that obviously the fish go for the bait, but the flavoring releases like an attractant, like a smell into the water that the fish go ooh. And it's often like insect protein or nuts or whatever naturally occurring prey that would attract them to that area. Indeed, I've taken up fishing recently, Dark P, as a hobby. Cannot withdraw the power cells. Why is that then, eh? Insufficient manufactured? That would be a bingo. Go to the main assembler and order me up another 200 batteries. Check the tooltip on the icons in the middle of the inventory screen. Tooltip on the icons in the middle of the inventory screen. Not sure what you mean, sorry. Battery. Click to add selected block variants or drag and drop to the block area here.
Oh.
Carp fishing, Killbot. So, fishing for fish in the carp family. Well, the common carp, yes, but also there are a bunch of other fish in that group. Battery cells. Whee! Oh, the inventory screen. Tooltips on the inventory screen. Middle of the inventory screen. Oh, withdraw oh, what's this? Withdraw components to 4 build planner. Hold control for times X. Deposit all ores, ingots. Ah. Add components from the build planner to the production queue. Oh, wow. Add selected components to the production queue or drop selected. So withdraw components for build planner. So that's the same as the middle mouse. Okay. Yeah, it's interesting. Cool. Yeah, so this is all new to me. This wasn't in Vanilla Space Engineers. So hang on. Build planner has a single battery, so yoink! Indeed, I hear that is true, yes. Carp, well, technically they're an invasive species here in the UK. But it seems that they've sort of gained a good reputation. They're a good fighting fish. They fight well on the line, effectively. Which means that they're very popular. Very popular indeed. Okay. Interior plates. So hang on. So let's try this. So interior. So stairs. So drag. No. Drag. Drop. Oh. Okay. Right. Sweet. Two sets of stairs. And then. I just need to see it. Okay. So what I'm doing now is I'm just sort of resetting the level of the deck. So this will be the new level. Or maybe one more. What would it look like from the inside? Ah, damn. Ah. Let me just kill that gravity generator. spherical gravity generator. Off. There we go. Pick those up later. Hang on, if I stand here. So yeah, within the ship. Oh, I still haven't sealed off this section, am I? Need to get more thruster components. Damn, that roof is still badly damaged. Hell, the whole thing isn't sealed and we've still got a reactor leak. Ooh, bugger. Bugger, bugger, bugger. Yeah, the ship did take extensive damage. We need to get the roof on and repair the jump drive. Damn, the destruction of the jump drive is a major problem. Please don't release them in random rivers as some people do. Indeed, that is one of the strict rules, very strict rule about moving fish from lake to lake. I think you can actually get prosecuted for that. Have I already convinced Dinklebean to play Space Engineers? Why? Is he doing it? I mentioned it to him, but I don't think he was that thrilled. I think he just doesn't know what it's about. Wait, what am I doing? Still got batteries in my inventory. That's what's taking up all the space. Oh, and the reactor components. Alright, one set of stairs. Up we go. Have I tried ocean fishing? Yes, when I was a teenager. So I got like a basic plastic rod as like a Christmas gift, which I'm sure many a young person gets. And I took it down to various harbour arms. So, you know, just areas, artificially built areas next to the ocean. So harbour arms and docks and stuff. And I caught a bunch of various different species. But as is the way when it comes to being a teenager, you don't really have the income to sustain such an expensive hobby. The moment a single piece of fishing gear was damaged, I was not in a position to replace it. Your pocket money of how like £10 a month or something can only go so far. Yeah. Right. Fishing rod, a gift for a young person. How old am I? 18? Still young? Still 18, it's fine. Okay, there we go. Reactor leak finished, repaired. Checking reactors. Both are still full of uranium. Very good. Would I lie to you? Of all the streamers and YouTubers, would I lie to you? Come on. The answer is yes. Hang on. Yeah, seriously, no, never trust me, for Christ's sake. Please. Never... I'm ZF for Christ's sake. I'm a bastard by default. Right, here we go. So I'm just moving the deck here. Sweet. And then, yeah, the thrusters will be down there. Right. Hell, I could always put like O2 generators here and here. Yeah, that could be a good place to put them actually, inside the hull, where they'll be relatively safe. Where are the refineries going to live? That's the next question. Could even move them underneath the floor. Thank you, Kaiser Carl and gentlemen. Thank you very much. Thank you sincerely. Hydrogen engines, oxygen farms. Oh yeah, there's oxygen farms now. What's the overall shape going to be then? Yeah, no wider than that, I think. The wing. And then the back end will be here. Where we'll have an ion thruster and a hydrogen thruster. Large, both. Okay, let's do that now. So a hydrogen thruster, large hydrogen thruster. So we'll let's put a conveyor. I got to think about defense, so turrets as well. Oh, wait, interior plates. Should be some over here, yes? Scattered on the floor. Awkwardly scattered on the floor. Okay, put that there. Okay. And then if I want, I can have turrets coming off here, you see? What's the largest fish I've caught? Well, I have caught carp before, but I never... Oh, dear. My construction vessel must have run out of power. It's fine. We'll stick something in its... we'll stick some uranium in its small reactor. Thank you, Julo. Yes, I can't tell you because I didn't record the fish weight back then, so I don't know. Right, large hydrogen thruster. Whoa. Yikes. Yikes indeed. Holy fuck nuggets. Inventory full. Alright, there we go. And then above and below we'll just put an ion thruster. But this thing will not be built for atmospherics. No way. Above or below? I got an idea. I'm going to put the ion thruster vertically and then make a sort of fin going off the back of it. Give it like a dorsal fin. Okay, steel plates, standby. It's the gear. Drop that off. It doesn't matter if I didn't record the weight, everyone makes it up. Yeah, it was this big, it was huge. Had red eyes and giant teeth. So yeah, the hydrogen thruster will sit there, and then this will be the spine of the ship, and then a dorsal fin will come up here. And that'll be my vessel. And then I'll put rows of heavy armor down the side. Turrets above and on the side. And maybe one underneath, like a missile turret or something. This is going to be a, well, presumably like a Corvette class ship. How did I get into Space Engineers? Like we played it years when it was first released, in fact. Years and years ago. Right, add to the build planner. Add to the build planner. Build planner. Yeah. Don't get burnt on the welders. Oh, build capacity reached. Alright. Whoops. The trouble is building these enormous. Yeah. I'm going to need the build ship for this. Way too big. So how can I tell what I'm grabbing, I suppose? Fix the thruster? What's wrong with the thruster? Oh yeah, I need to get... Wait, so this hydrogen tank, stand by. Hydrogen tank temp. Fill the other two. Stockpile on, stockpile on. Cool. Drain this one, then we'll remove this. Yeah, it's cool looking, isn't it? Inventory full. Oopsie. The ion thruster is off-center. Is it? Oh yeah, so it is. Oh, bum, is it not three blocks? So, there goes my dorsal plan idea. My dorsal fin thing. It's only two blocks. Well, doesn't necessarily scupper it entirely. I can just do a row of smaller ions, couldn't I? Like this. They're only one block, right? Yeah, like a row of like six or six, like up and yeah, should be fine. Thank you, Heinz. Thank you very much, Heinz. Thank you sincerely. No, it'll be fine. I'll just use smaller ones. It's all good. It's all good. So now go to the build planner and cancel the large ion thruster. And just do the light armor blocks in the other bits. Whee! Ouch. Bloody hell, is that the time? Time flies. Soon to get on with work in a few minutes. Work takes the form of Rocket League bullshittery part 1. So far, so good. Just kind of cracking on, really. Alright. Thrust components. Let's go to the front and remove this tank. Oh yeah, we need to queue up the superconductors for the jump drive. Get that restored. Yes. What have I got in my inventory? Grids. It's over here. Yada da 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 da.
Energy low.
But yeah. Work, he says, indeed.
Inventory full.
Sitting there editing and just sort of staring mindlessly at the screen. It's really not very exciting. It's very, very tedious. Okay. Thank you, to Sunday. Thank you very much, to Sunday. R3 bound. So I think the idea is now, if you just sort of go to the... So there's some sort of ZF Discord. Apparently, if you just find Social and CF Mag on there, and just ask... You say that you've got Space Engineers and you'd like to partake.
Energy low.
I think they're just sort of... They're just going to start adding people to the whitelist, and then I guess until it seems too full. So yeah, I guess just pop on in. I guess, truth be told, it's not very well organized. It's ZF. What do you expect? Okay. Right. They'll ask you me to vouch for them. I don't think so. I think they're just trying to get people now. I don't know. Social's the person to ask. What's the Discord for ZF? I have no idea. I don't use Discord. So I know I'm not being very helpful here. I have no idea. So what's that over there? Two enemy signals. Oh, Space Sweden. All right. Steel plates. All right. That thruster is going to be a nightmare. How many friend requests on Steam and Discord do I get a day? I don't know. The Steam friends, this is bugged, so I can't seem to add or remove anybody, which is weird. Thank you, Homemade Globe. Thank you very much, Homemade. And I don't have Discord. What is ZF anyway? It's just a clan. Okay, metal grids, steel plates. Why don't I use Discord? I couldn't. I just don't have the time. We use TeamSpeak to play anyway. As in the clan. Setting up a different thing is all well and good, but all it would do is split up the clan into different areas. And I just don't have the time to use another social media thing. Or, you know what I mean, as in another platform to be around on and message and stuff. I barely check Twitter, Facebook once a month. You know, well, not once a month, but you know, yeah, barely at all. I've got 4,000 unread emails. I've got all the Patreon messages that I'm trying to go through along with the Twitch. So subscriber messages through my email, but it's the same really, it's email as well. I'm already completely overloaded. And I'm not the kind of YouTuber who has like social media managers, so it's just me. Right.
Do you understand what I'm trying to tell you?
Cool. So both hydrogen... So these now should be equally full, yes? Hydrogen tank, 6% apiece. Excellent. Switch off stockpiling. Hydrogen tanks have a little bit of fuel, but it would be nice to get them more ice so they can process it in the meantime. So. What's left to build? What's that? Large hydrogen thrusters built. Hang on. Looking good though, isn't it? Gradually coming together.
Do you understand what I'm trying to tell you?
Need to get those underside thrusters built. I wonder, just thinking about it before we go, if I were to get these ion thrusters going, I could go to the ice field and try and get some ice for it to process in the meantime, maybe? Let's just try and get these going, hang on. So, wait, how does it work again? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So just thruster components, a whole load of them. Cannot withdraw them. Is that because we do not have them? Let's have a look. Production. Oh, that's a bad sign. Damn. Thruster components. We have insufficient gold. Damn. Which means I'm going to have to get up in orbit in order to get access to the gold asteroid. There's some naturally occurring here, but it's not common. Right. Well, I wonder if we have sufficient hydrogen to get to the ice field. Let's have a look. Because, look, we've got downwards-facing hydrogen thrusters. 4 of them. Right? We've got the ion thrusters already. So, forwards, backs, back, side. Maybe? Maybe is the answer. Let's have a look. How much actual... Well, we've got about 12%, haven't we? 6%. 6%? Okay, 6%. So let's just test it. Here we go. Switch off all these signals because they're going to be confusing. Oops. Right. We're up. Okay, very gently now. If we get in trouble, we'll just come down to land. So long as we're in the shield, we'll be alright. Trouble is that rear thruster is going to be really thirsty. So just tiny little blips forward. Those ion thrusters are trying to undo my efforts though. It's annoying. Can I switch those off? Sorry. Ion thrusters, backwards. Damn you. Backwards. Off. Okay, just drift. There we go. So here's the energy shield that marks the safe zone. So we're just about to leave it. So this is being generated by a shield generator mounted inside the moon base. And what I'm just going to very gently do is drift the large ship over to the ice field nearby. We've built the crater next to a large, like, lunar pole. Okay, 5%. So, yeah, we should be alright. We might not make it back. We'll have to see. It's nice and gentle now, okay? Pick up a bit of speed. Got to about 40 meters per second. It's cool though, isn't it? It's a cool looking ship. So, imagine the back being fully encased in armor. And then we'll take off the drill front and maybe put something a bit more fearsome. There's the ice sheet. Right, let's now reactivate the backwards ion thrusters and order them to begin. Just one moment. There we go. Oh, cool. Social's linked the Discord thing. Thank you. Thank you, Social. Inertial dampeners off. Just drift down. That safe zone isn't turned on. Should be. How can you tell? Thank you, Sneaky Turtle. Thank you very much, Sneaky. Thank you, sir. You can keep spamming until you hear me say it. All they need to do is look at the pinned message, says Social. Okay. Pinned message. Very gently now. Okay, so look at the pinned message on the Discord there. Sorry, Social, I'm trying to not explode. Can't really read chat a minute. Okay, so ship nose forward. Drill pieces activated. Question is how many... Okay, so... I mean, 4 reverse ion thrusters, so we need to be very careful. This, if the ship's mass gets to the point that the ion thrusters can't take it, then we abort. Otherwise, this thing nosedives. Here we go. Gently, gently. Monitor the situation closely. We might have to right ourselves. Okay, so I'm scraping the top layer of ice from this glacier. It's not really a glacier, it's a pole, isn't it? Thank you, the mythic legend. Thank you very much, sir. Poles being so cold due to the fact that they get very little sunlight based on the angle that they face the star that they're orbiting. As in, the less atmosphere that the sunlight has to go through, the warmer the surface, because obviously more radiation is reaching the surface and heating it up, which is why the equator is super hot. But as you start to get higher and higher up on the sphere of a world, the radiation has to pass through more and more atmosphere as it negotiates the curve. And when eventually you get to the poles, it has to go through a huge amount of atmosphere just to touch the ground. Which is why poles are fucking freezing. Mostly. Not always. Okay. Reverse up. That's not the reason. No, that is the reason. Actually, yeah. That is the reason. That's the primary reason why poles are so cold and the equator is fucking hot. It's to do with the amount of atmosphere that the radiation has to go through. Right, there we go. Good. There we go. 210,000 units of ice. So hang on. O2. Yeah, brilliant. I have 2 O2 generators and they're still connected up. So they are now processing the fuel. Stand by. Where's the base? There it is. No way, that's Alistair's base. Don't fuck this up. You don't have the fuel. There we go. Off we go. Let's... do the same thing that I did before. So backwards ion thrusters, disable those. Right the angle. 5% fuel. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Dobbin, that's not the reason. The reason is the angle of the sun rays connecting with the surface. That's exactly what I'm describing. The angle of the radiation having to travel through more atmosphere because of the angle of the surface relative to the star. That's exactly what I'm saying. On the equator, that angle is next to nil, so it just goes bloop, straight to the surface. And also, a big chunk of it is reflection as well. Once you start to get ice, ice is extremely reflective. So it just starts bouncing off radiation. Which is one of the problems, because once a planet starts losing its ice cover, then, well, the greenhouse gas problem just starts accelerating, because suddenly you have less solar reflection. Okay, 4% fuel. We're okay. We did it. Oh, no, that's a good point, Jay. Yes, I haven't figured out how that works yet. So someone says something about flux, flux generators or something mounted on the ship will determine the shield. Yeah, I'd like to figure that out. Because a shield generator would be useful. It's a modded thing, apparently. Yeah, it's a good point. Say it after I land. Just get back safely. Meridian class MK1 is its current designation. We need to call it MK2, though. Here we go. No, the modded thing is the latest patch of Space Engineers. Putting in safe zones, allowing you to keep the shit that you don't want destroyed in PvP safe. They're fairly easy to maintain. Inertial dampeners off. Let's not burn fuel as we go down. Nice and careful. Yes, Mark III, if I don't pay attention. Yeah. Oh dear, something just exploded. Oh, it's fine. The ion thrusters are melting the skirting. Right, I see. Just bad design. I can fix that. Just remove the skirting. Nice and slow. Once the ship gets sufficiently large, it's a good idea to put cameras all over it so you can see in various different directions on a hotkey press. Thank you, Noodle. Thank you, sir. Careful, don't crush my own construction vessel. Or that spherical generator, because I probably want the components. Down and locked in place. Excellent. Standby. 8 hours of power in its reactors. Why is that the case? 12 hours of power. Its battery. Oh, it has a single battery. I see. That's part of the problem. Thank you, Cactus. Thank you, Cactus. Right. Here's one O2 generator, which is working to convert. You can hear it whirring away. It's working to convert the ice that we've just picked up and put it as hydrogen in these two tanks. Fantabulous. Okay. Thank you, Methox. Thank you very much, Methox. Thank you sincerely. Right. Okay. Nice. That worked. What's the time? It's already 4 minutes past one. Okay. Need to bugger off in a minute. Yeah, cool. So we've got a whole load of ice that it's turning into fuel. Thruster components, damn, yeah, I'm going to need the gold, which is up in space. That's the trouble, so we need more fuel to get up there. Okay, right, so I'm going to bugger off. So, yeah, have a good day, folks. Cheers for watching. Thank you, Jolon. Thank you very much, Jolon. Yeah, so have a lovely evening. Lovely morning and afternoon. I'm going to be back later on, so it's just time to go and get to work on... what is it? So, Rocket League bullshittery. Okay, so... just going to save that blueprint. Go over here. Hang on. 8 hours is probably not a huge amount of time, so let me just tell it to... stand by. Tell the O2 generators to chill for the minute. Battery power. 14 days. There we go. So the ship has 14 days of power on its current configuration. Right. Hi there, Messi. Charming. Bloody charming. Let's go back to cryo. That way, when I log off, my character and all of its inventory will be saved. There we go. Okay. Right. So, have a lovely, lovely afternoon, folks. I'm going to go crack on with Rocket League Bullshittery Part 1. And, yeah. All right, hang on. Just pop out of there. Okay. I see. I'll be back at around 8 o'clock. I think Edberg suggested possibly doing a bit of Mordhau, as in the fighting game with the people yelling at each other wearing buckets on their head. So maybe, yeah, I'd be up for that if he's up for it. Okay, so yeah, I'll be back later doing something, figure out what then. Hang on a minute. So ZF. So Edberg's on, he's playing Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Kaf is playing Minecraft, Yuki is playing Destiny 2. Okay, I'm going to hand you over to Edberg then. So he's currently playing as a anthropomorphic blob pink thing with a sword that's attacking Luigi for some reason. Sorry, Green Mario. Right. So, all the best. Thank you again. Have a lovely afternoon. And, see you again soon.